The Biopsy Playhouse has been rated TV-PG. Parental guidance suggested.
Rims, use Chapstick Plus.
Something seems wrong and oh so twisted. Nonetheless, this is comedy as insisted. We making more chronicles than Riddick. We in it for 30 minutes, getting down and dirty like the last apartment you rented. When it comes to laughter, we consider the best. You just dealt with drama, now get rid of the mess. Gone ahead and kick your shoes off. But if the beat stank, put them back on, cause it's time to light the fuse off.
Tulips.
Tulips? Yeah, you can play your tulips right here.
Can we watch this?
Buddy, we'll watch whatever you want.
Okay.
It's a flower shop.
Wow.
They got those pink tulips just like you like.
Yeah, my favorite.
We should get some for the apartment. What do you think?
Yeah. Oh, Sid. Oh, Sid. Oh, yeah.
What Sid. The hell are you doing? What's wrong with you? Give me that. Why is the couch wet? You faggot. You're so gay. Man, that's a good stuff. But like I was saying, heading down the road to Las Colinas, old truck breaks down. I think it's my alternator. Gonna cost me a bill. Turns out it's a battery. They come out and test it for free. What do you think about that, man?
What do I think about that? Look, man, I just asked you to go back to the truck, get us some more beer. Now you're just telling about your car problem. You're telling you going down to car zone, get your truck fixed. What the hell are you talking about, man? This is your friend right here, man. I swear to God, man. This is the last time we bring him. Talking about car zone. What the hell is wrong with you, man?
I could be a fighter. I could be a fighter. I could be a fighter.
Thank you.
chump.
Sally, and I'm a mother. Welcome to tonight's meeting for Mothers for Drunk Driving. I'm very excited tonight. We're going to welcome a new member. Michael, would you please come to the front and take the oral exam and oath?
Okay there, teach.
Michael, are you ready to take the oral exam?
Oral? Maybe the vaccine in my car would be better for you to give me oral.
No, silly, oral exam. Now for your first question, if you were to hit this old lady, how many points would it be worth?
I could give a crap. I don't know. 10?
Good effort, Michael, but that's the wrong answer. Can anyone tell me the correct answer?
Well, Sally, I believe the answer is 20 points.
That's correct, Johnny. Now why don't you chug that beer down as your reward?
Chug, 50.
Very good, Michael. You're catching on. Now for your last question. How many points is this worth?
That's the pig who busted me last week. I hate that guy. 100 points.
Great job, Michael. You passed the test. Now repeat the oath after me. I promise to always drive drunk, never follow traffic laws, and if you're stopped, never admit you're drunk.
I promise. Drive drunk. Traffic. Amen.
Saved it!
Okay, Michael. That's all for tonight. Anyone who wants to volunteer for the Make Breathalyzers Illegal Rally this weekend, sign up here. Remember, be safe, drive drunk, and I'll see most of you next week.
What are you so excited for now?
Oh, I went to this new restaurant in town called Pooters.
What's a Pooters?
Oh, they sell hot dogs. And I got my name on the wall. I'm a celebrity.
What'd you do to get your name on the wall?
I swallowed whole 6 hot wieners. Yeah.
How many did you swallow after you set the record?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12.
Get away from me. Hey. God, you're so gay. You get a new roommate.
Whoa, man, wait.
It's okay, I brought it for protection.
What do you protect us from?
Squirrels, man, they're after our nuts.
Your nuts?
He's your friend.
He's your friend last week.
What you doing there, boy?
It ain't boy, it's George.
What you doing there, boy George?
It ain't boy George neither. It's George Jefferson, honky, and I'm moving on up to the big house.
I am so depressed.
No more cotton in the fields. Took a whole lot of trying and just
can't touch this. George Washington Jefferson, don't you go no further. What do you want, Mama? Well, you're not going anywhere till you do your chores. But Mama, I gotta take a shipment of Daddy Tom's crops to the Underground Railroad.
I'm proud of you, son, helping out the black man.
I'm out of here.
What you doing, boy? You can't use the front door.
Watch me, honky.
I have a terrible feeling trouble may be rearing its ugly head.
No crap, just like his father. No good trifling bastard. What ungrateful chaff turkey, I tell you what. This right here was smoked by Benjamin Franklin. We know he was a party animal. Now, can I get five?
$5.
You got here, ten.
Ten.
Ten, I like your spirit. Can I get 15? 15. Oh, you got 20, okay, I know that.
25.
25, oh man, going once, going twice. Ooh, you gonna get high tonight, boy, ooh, yeah.
What is your name, son?
My name is George Washington Jefferson, honky.
What is this honky you speak of?
I bet it's your accomplice, isn't it? So tell me, how is the war going? I miss the glory days.
The tired King George has extended me for another 6 months. I heard news that he's going to extend...
How to invent a dry clean machine.
I tell you, it's much more than that.
House is now on fire.
George, what did you do to my cart?
Oh, don't worry about it, Daddy. I made it better because I pimped your ride.
This is an outrage. I can't believe... What is this? Can't believe I have such a good son. £1,000. Another £1,000. You have hundreds of thousands of pounds in here.
Oh, I knew that would shut you up. Now I'm gonna take my cut and help out the revolution.
First, you were brought the reality of roots. Then you rode on the Amistad. Now we show you the Jeffersons.
So, Tedman, did you hear Lady Winchester bought her sons two matching Bentleys?
Why no, Francis. What spoiled children is she raising?
Well, what do you propose we do about this? You know, to keep them from growing up to be spoiled young adults?
Well, the same thing we do every week, Francis. We solve the mystery of the missing Bentleys. That is, after we steal them and sell them online.
Well, Sheriff, we found this paintbrush next to Lady Winchester's garage. That means the burglar has to be a painter.
That's right, Francis. I believe the last painter we saw was last month, right after painting our room. What a coincidence.
Yes, Tedman, that does sound quite suspicious, doesn't it? You should go arrest this burglar right now.
It's pretty damning evidence, gentlemen. How do you two solve these cases? Somebody ought to write a book about you two. So what's next, you two wild super sleuths?
Well, as a matter of fact, we may have a lead on that jewel theft that happened last week. Let me tell you about it. If you want me to know, after it's good stuff. So anyways, old Jenny Lou come by the house last weekend. Grandpa going to test her out for the big wedding.
Test her? Test her out for what?
Test her out, see if she's good enough for her husband. She ain't good enough for family. She ain't good enough for no one else. Come on now.
This guy.
Man, where are you from?
Bixby.
What?
Hi, everybody. We've gone back in time here to Richard III's castle. Now, because Richard III has such a thirst for the Crusades, his royal coffers are bare.
Bare.
Oh, anyway.
We have 2 days and only 100 pence to redesign this whole castle, or else. See if we can do it.
King Richard, we are just so excited to work with you on this project. Now, with every show, we have to find a starting place, so what would you like to redesign first?
The privy! The old cripple spends most of his time there!
Will you shut up? You're not funny! He's not funny! Sorry about my jester. I found him working in a club downtown doing stand-up. He was all I could afford. Anyway, look, I've had a lot of nasty and bad comments about my great hall, so I was hoping you could start there first. What do you think?
You're the boss, I mean king.
It's good to be the king.
Well, your lordship, right off there's no color, no theme, no...
Nothing, I tell ya. He spent all of his money on that so-called holy war, the Crusades. I tell you, a lot of good Englishmen have lost their lives based on a lie. We have nothing left. We starve so we can have his so-called war. His coffers are bare.
What is your damage, Jester? Insulting me, your king, is not funny or wise. You know, if you continue this mockery of your king, I'm gonna turn you into a football! You know, I wanted a jester, not Don Rickles! You were saying?
Bear. Oh, sorry, this is what I envisioned. Lots of bright curtains, and we're gonna resurface this table. It's gross, girl. It's just disgusting. Anyway, we're gonna put lots of bright pillows and flowers. Lots of flowers, and you'll be the talk of the kingdom. It'll be gorgeous!
So, Bubby, how long is this gonna take, Fangela?
One day, your kingship.
Oh, it better take one day, and you better be under budget, or else, off with your head! It's good to be the king. Come on, pygmy. Mush, mush, mush!
Well, there you have it, folks. We have one day, 100 pence, to redesign this great hall and make it fit for a king, or, one of us is gonna be about 12 inches shorter. We'll be right back. Okay, well, thank you for your help, Mr. Jester. I think we're ready for the king's inspection.
No problem. I just felt sorry for you. I hope you have an exit strategy.
You're just so silly.
Oh, my God! You did the job, and you did it on the budget. But there's one thing, Fangela. Do the guys in the tin can suits have to be holding flowers and not weapons?
Well, your kingship, they put people at ease, and you spoke of peace, making peace with the rest of the kingdom, yes? What better way than with flowers? Hello? Silly.
You know, there's something about this room that's really bothering me. I can't put my finger on it.
How about gay, queer, light on its feet?
I got it, Jester, I got it. The room looks gay. This won't do. The next time I have guests, they'll think they're having it in a Turkish harem. Oh my God, they'll think I'm gay!
Probably because you are!
I'm not gay!
You know, I knew there was something about that king. He's a queen!
I'm not gay! Stop this nonsense immediately! Look, madam, I do not like your redesign, and I really, really hate gay people!
Probably because you are!
Quiet, Chester! Guards, take this man off and behead him, off with his head, whatever.
Say head?
The king's out of the closet. You're picking Daisy. You love the Wizard of Oz.
I'm not gay! And everybody loves the Wizard of Oz. Especially Dorothy in that dress. Gorgeous, gorgeous, Buffy, gorgeous. What are you talking about?
The king, you're gay.
I'm not gay!
Raise your hand if you're a homo.
I'm not queer.
You're gay, you're gay.
No, I'm not gay. I'm not. Yeah. No, no.
Yes, you are. Oh. Yes, you are. Well, we redesigned the Great Hall of this wonderful castle in time and under budget. Join us next week when we redesign Attila the Hun's main tent. I've got to go or I'm going to lose my head. TTFN.
Hi. Before Kugel, stalking my ex-girlfriend would be such a hassle. I mean, I would physically have to look everywhere, which takes forever. I remember going down and calling every number just till I found her new number. But now, with Kugel, I just type it in and boom,
email, address, phone, everything. Yep, Kugel's made my life a lot better. A lot better.
We're making more chronicles than Riddick. We in it for 30 minutes, getting down and dirty like the last apartment you rented. When it comes to laughter, we consider the best. You just dealt with drama, now get rid of the mess. Gone ahead and kick your shoes off, but if the beat stank, put them back on, cause it's time to light the fuse off.
Biopsy Playhouse, what you know about it? On your TV and on the internet. Biopsy Playhouse, what you know about it? On your TV.
Check it out, without a doubt, we're making laugh out loud. Now playing on your screen, biopsy got you whacked out now. Keep it in store for last, cause we running this apartment. Let this be a warning, the episode starting. Wild like Martin, we'll show you what's up. We don't make one joke here and there, they come in clusters. Now the game's split like Sterling, remember the name. Trust me when I say TV will never be the same. This is
biopsy
out loud. Now playing on your screen, biopsy got you whacked out now. Keep it in store for last, cause we running this apartment. Let this be a warning, the episode starting. Wild like Martin, we'll show you what's up. We don't make one joke here and there, they come in clusters. Now the game's split like Sterling, remember the name. Trust me when I say TV will never be the same. This is
biopsy playing.